صلى الله عليك يا سيدي ويا مولاي يا أبا عبد الله، صلى الله وسلم عليك يا سيدي ويا مولاي وابن مولاي يا ابن رسول الله يا رحمة الله الواسعة ويا باب نجاة الأمة ويا عبرة كل مؤمن ومؤمنة، ما خاب من تمسك بكم وأمن من لجأ والتجأ إليكم، يا ليتنا كنا معكم سادتي فنفوز فوزا عظيما. Amongst one of the family members and the beloveds of Aba Abdullah that fell as a martyr in the day of Ashura was his nephew Qasim ibn al-Hassan salamullahi alayh. Qasim was raised in the household of Aba Abdullah. Aba Abdullah al-Hussein took care of him, and he watched Qasim grow as his father Hassan had died when Qasim was very young. When Imam Hassan died, they took his body to the grave of Rasulullah and they wanted to bury him there. However, the enemy stopped Aba Abdullah from burying his brother Hassan next to the grave of Rasulullah. They came and they stopped him, and they even threw arrows at the grave of him, at the body of Imam Hassan al-Mujtaba. Aba Abdullah al-Hussein was told by Imam Hassan that if you take me to my grandfather Rasulullah, they will not allow you to bury me there. Do not fight them and do not kill them and do not have any bloodshed next to the grave of Rasulullah. Imam Hussein told them, then allow him to say his goodbyes to his grandfather. They went, they put the body next to the grave. Then they picked up the body. As she came and she told them to remove the body of your son from my house. Imam Hussein took the body. They went to Baqi'. He was about to bury the body of Imam Hassan and to the grave. He asked them, where is my brother Abbas? I want him to help me put my brother Hassan into the grave. They looked around, where is Abbas? Is he in the crowd? Where has he gone? They couldn't find Abbas. Abbas, where are you? They went all the way back to the Masjid of Rasulullah. They saw Abbas standing in front of the grave of Rasulullah. He has taken his amama off. In his hand, he is shaking and crying. Aba Abdullah told him, Ya Abbas, what is it that makes you stand here? He says, Ya Aba Abdullah, when I saw them remove my brother Hassan from this grave of his grandfather and where he shall be buried, I could not bear. I have become angry and nervous. Aba Abdullah, allow me to pick up my sword. Aba Abdullah tells him, Ya Abbas, it is not your day today. He took Abbas, they put Hassan in the grave. They removed the kafan, they put the cheek of Imam Hassan on the sand, and they looked the last time at the face of Imam Hassan al-Mujtaba. On the day of Ashura, Qasim ibn al-Hassan, They say that he was a very young man, maybe at the age of 13 or 14. He walked into the tent of his uncle Hussein. His uncle Hussein told him, Qasim, what is it that makes you come to the tent? He says, Ya Aam, i'dhalli bil qital. Oh, my uncle Hussein, allow me to go and march towards the enemies. Aba Abdullah looked at his face and he remembered the last moments where he put his brother's cheek on the dust. He remembered his brother Hassan. He told him, Qasim, you are the only memory left for this household from my brother Hassan. I cannot allow you to go. Narration say Qasim fell to the feet of his uncle Hussein. He began to tell him, Ya Am, oh my beloved uncle, please allow me to go. He began to even kiss the feet of Aba Abdullah, begging his uncle, pleading to his uncle, crying to him, allow me to go and march towards the enemies. Aba Abdullah told him, hold on. He went and he brought him the turban of his father Hassan and the sword of his father Hassan and the aba of his father Hassan. He put the amamah on his head. He put the qaba on his back. He gave him the sword of his father Hassan and he put him on the horse of his father Hassan. He told him, march towards the enemies. Hassan, the Qasim ibn al-Hassan, marched to the enemies. This young man, they say when he came to us, the enemies say this, they say, we looked at his face, وَكَانَ وَجْهُهُ كَالْقَمَرِ فِي لَيْلَةِ تَمَامِهِ وَكَمَالِهِ. His face was like the moon, shining with light. He went to them and he began to march and he began to chant to them. And tankaroni fa'ana najlul Hassan, sibtun nabiy al-Mustafa wal-mu'taman, adhrubukum bis-sayf dar بغلامين هاشمين مؤتمن. He began to fight them. He began to kill them one by one. Then his shoelace opened. He ducked to go and pick up his shoelace and tie his shoelace. They took that opportunity. They hit and they strike Qasim on his head. He fell on the sands. He shouted out, Ya Am, adrikni, oh my uncle Hussein, come to my rescue. Aba Abdullah went to him. فذهب إليه الحسين كالصقر المنقض. He went to him like an eagle and he landed on the body of Qasim. He was in his last moments. He put Qasim in his lap. He put him towards the Qibla. He told him, Bunayya Qasim, soon you will see your father Hassan. You will see your grandfather Ali. You will your grandmother Fatima and Rasulullah. Give them my salam and tell them that your uncle Hussein is coming nearly. He put Qasim's body towards the Qibla. He says, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. وأشهد أن محمد رسول الله. Qasim's spirit and soul separated from this dunya to the akhirah while he was smiling in his uncle's lap. رحم الله من نادى ومظلوما وسيدا وشهيدا. Imam Hussein salamullahi alayh took the body of Qasim. He shouted out to Bani Hashim, come and pick up the body of your cousin and put it next to the tent. His mother came, his aunt came, and the ladies came. They saw the body of Qasim and they began to cry and to shout and to say that you were the only one that reminded us of our brother Hassan. Why did you leave? Was the greatest tragedy upon the household of Rasulullah. It was one of the tragedies that will never be forgotten in the day of Ashura. As-salamu ala al-Husayn wa ala Ali ibn al-Husayn wa ala awlad al-Husayn wa ala ashab al-Husayn.